Hello, and welcome to Island Club Apartments in Metro West Orlando. I'm a former resident there who was there for 2 years, and as beautiful as this sign looks, I'm here to tell you why it is the worst place to live and why you should avoid it at all costs. Again, me and my wife lived here for 2 years. When we first got here, it was under a different management group. At some point, early on, it got taken over by Michelson Group, and much like this broken gate right here, we just felt no sense of security with these people. Those gates were broken the majority of the time, and I'm here to tell you a lot of other reasons why you should avoid this place. Don't fall for the facade out front with the flags and the beautiful blue sign and water. As soon as you come in, you're going to notice just how unkempt and poorly maintained this place is. Never have I ever seen landscapers actually package up these leaves. They just come out every Tuesday or Thursday or something and they just blow them off to the side. The entire apartment complex looks like that. Just leaves and dead shrubbery everywhere. This is actually where when the tennis court doesn't look as bad. But even if you can't tell from this particular video clip, there's actually dog crap all over in the corners back there. This tennis court was hardly used for tennis. It was used for dogs to crap in and for people to play. Oh, and again, a broken gate. So yes, out of the 2 years I was here, I would say only a couple months were these gates operational. There's two of them. There's two of them that you can use a card key to get into. You know, if you get in safely and somebody doesn't cut you off in the process, because that's just the kind of people that live there. You know, more leaves. I'll get to some exciting stuff here in a minute. Just like this gym. Yeah, you're paying for amenities here, but these rules right here, they mean nothing. I guess I'll show you some leaves one more time. Yeah. Imagine living in the city or an apartment where you can't wash your car, you have to go through a car wash. And then parking here and having your day ruined by leaf blowers who don't even bag the crap, they just blow it all over your car. This particular three-way intersection right here is of important notice because it's a major safety violation. There's no stop sign. There is no stop sign at this three-way intersection. And when you're coming down that road, your view is obstructed by the trash can. The dumpster that's on the left-hand side of this frame right here, you can't see. So you have to approach those speed bumps or any part of this carefully, otherwise you might have a minor collision, which I have seen happen in almost a couple of times. I've almost seen a couple of near collisions and at other places too. People just run any stop signs that are here. Here's a little bit of positivity. There's a lot of feral cats here, a lot of neighborhood cats, and that's actually nice. None of them are bad, they're all good cats. I just wanted to put a little bit of positivity in here to make it kind of humane. But anyway, let's get back to the gym. That place where rules don't mean crap. Sorry, I'm trying not to curse in this. This is actually not as bad as it normally looks. Usually I would walk in and fix it. Oh, that motion sensor camera doesn't mean anything. Sure, they might have the app on their phones, but it being under surveillance means nothing. These weights, these busted up benches right here, were there the entire time. I had heard several times from management, oh, we're gonna order new stuff, we're gonna replace the weights, we're gonna fix the place up. Nope, same chewed up, disgusting, beaten up, tetanus riddled weights that were always there. No type of sanitary items, nothing. I had to supply my own crap just so I could have a free gym for a while, but eventually I started going to my own. This is still the gym. That serves no purpose. That water cooler machine doesn't belong there. It doesn't do anything. If you're a little queasy, I would recommend skipping this next part. Hold on. This back door right here that I'm looking out of, people would leave it unlocked so that they could sneak people in because you need a card key to get into the gym. But people would sneak in here all the time. There'd be all these teenage boys not wearing shirts. People sneaking in people from outside of the place. Here it is. Here's the nasty part. Yeah. No toilet paper, no paper towels, no hand soap. It was like this the entire time I lived here. ill-fitted toilet seat do not give a crap about their tenants. Here's the nasty part. Yeah, it wasn't too out of the question to see anything like that. But if you think that's bad, why don't you just have a nice little look at this outside toilet? Yeah, that's the pool toilet. The toilet by the pool. Anyway, back to the gym. No upkeep on any of the machines. You know, if you want to do some hip sled or some leg presses, enjoy the possibility of ending up in a saw-like death trap. Now, racquetball courts are supposed to be kind of beaten up looking, but these were still poorly maintained. People would just come in here to hang out and not even use it for its appropriate uses half the time. Here's another broken machine, the pull-up assist. Yeah, good luck trying to fix that. This clip right here is intended to show you where people usually snuck in. So there's three sets of gates. There's the two that you can that are broken open, but then there's these over here. People would hop these gates, or they'd climb under. I don't know. People would sneak in, use the pools, use the gym, and they didn't even live here. And there wasn't even any security. So screw the idea of surveillance. It means nothing. There used to be security when I first started out here, but over time it just went away. And there were instances. Like, you see this graveyard of toilets? It's really indicative of how they treat their tenants. It's a metaphor of how they view their tenants. Just a graveyard of toilets. Who cares if these tenants have been harassed by outsiders or minors or people that do not belong here, do not live here, do not pay rent here? It does not matter. And if you go and address management with your security concern, they blame the victim. That's something that's happened. Now let's actually get to some more meat here. There were a couple of unauthorized maintenance projects. This was the aftermath of repiping the building. I get having a lease and them having to do stuff, but it was all done so horrifically. That's the new toilet. That's another positive thing right there. But oh, maintenance. There's that outdoor light that took you 3 weeks to replace. That's what it looked like. Yeah, I couldn't even get to my door. I couldn't see it. Had a hard time unlocking it. I had to use my iPhone flashlight. Thanks a lot. I had to kind of hound them to get all of my, what do you call it, all my old-ass appliances replaced. Thank God I had the maintenance supervisor's cell phone number. Oh, this was supposed to be at the end, but there's a $100 fee out of my security deposit for cleaning up after I moved out. Here's a notice. You can pause it. Here's a notice for the, you know, these are all notices for repiping and toilets and crap. They give you a little bit of notice, but they don't realize how inconvenient it is, how it takes maintenance a long time to go fix your sink, you know? You know, plumbers breaking stuff. When they took the fridge out, that's what it looked like right there. They had to re-wall that. That is what I moved into. Yeah, the model home doesn't look anything like this. It looks nice. This is what I moved into. You know, a place with broken dumbbells. You know, who cares about tetanus or safety, right? There's, you know, more broken crap right there. You saw it from the video. That fitness stuff was all the same. But I'd like to keep talking about the maintenance thing. You know, the third-party contractors that they use for these maintenance projects, for the most part, were highly unprofessional, did not care how invasive they were. If I didn't have my cats locked up in my room, they could have gotten out because they would leave the doors unlocked, wide open. Who cares about my energy bill, right? You know? And, yeah, they didn't stock up the sanitary wipes ever, so I had to bring my own Lysol and paper towels to sanitize equipment. But yeah, these third-party people that Michelson Group or Island Club uses outside of maintenance, they're terrible. Only a handful of them were polite. The pressure washers that have, you know, used my spigot out in the hallway in the past have flooded my kitchen numerous times until I put up a sign that said, "Do not use." I had so many serious issues at this apartment where if I was not on top of management, if I wasn't, you know, kind of an asshole to them, I wouldn't have gotten things done. So it's a good thing. That's the broken pipe right there. Avoid Island Club at all costs. I am keeping this video to 10 minutes. These people will take holidays whenever they feel like it, out even outside of regular holidays. They don't care. And maintenance people, we'll just leave all the keys out. Right there, right out in the open. Who cares about security, right? Avoid Island Club!